Should you go it alone or look for safety in numbers? Why might an animal choose to live on its own? An animal that lives on its own has less direct competition for food and can blend in with its environment easier than animals living in larger groups. A solitary animal can disappear into a forest and blend with the brush. But an animal that lives alone has no one to watch its back. Triceratops already has a sight disadvantage. Its large frill and horns block vision to the side and rear. When a triceratops sticks its head into a bush to feed, it is virtually blind. A solo triceratops would need to pay close attention to its environment, constantly on guard for sounds that could mean approaching danger. Why might an animal choose to live in a group? Animals that live in groups always have someone to watch their back. You may have your snout in a bush, but another animal in the group or herd will always be on the lookout. Herds can't blend in with their environment. Predators nearly always know the location of the herd. Tyrannosaurs may have followed behind herds of triceratops, like lions follow herds of wildebeest today. An animal living in a herd is hiding in plain sight. A predator attack will occur, and a member of the herd might be killed. But animals that live in herds depend on the odds, and odds are, although someone is getting eaten, it's probably not going to be you. Probably. Did triceratops really live in herds? We would have to find the remains of a herd of triceratops to know for sure. And right now, all we found are small groups. But scientists have found the remains of herds of close relatives, and so triceratops may have lived in herds as well. Different species of modern animals can live different lifestyles. The white rhino lives in small herds, while the black rhino is a solitary creature. So it is possible that triceratops could have lived alone or in small groups, while a close relative may have lived in giant herds.